Quando sono arrivata qui a novembre, quasi subito abbiamo chiuso il museo e quindi questo museo era totalmente silenzioso e noi eravamo chiusi dentro queste sale meravigliose, le sale in cui si pensa che sia nato il barocco che ha riportato in vita questo concetto della poesia e della pittura come delle sorelle. E la sintesi delle arti che si crea nel barocco, soprattutto grazie a Gian Lorenzo Bernini, aveva infatti delle radici molto antiche, che erano quelle della poesia latina, in cui per la prima volta si parlava di questa vicinanza tra la poesia e la pittura. E oggi queste sale si sono di nuovo riempite di parole poetiche, di parole di cui ringraziamo moltissimo Rodney Ford, e sono le parole di Lorenzo Ferlinghetti. A novembre avevamo pensato con tutti quanti i colleghi della galleria di leggere questa poesia e di leggerla nelle sale del museo. E quindi oggi invece queste parole sono diventate un ricordo, ma hanno per noi lo stesso valore, un valore di una grandissima speranza. E la speranza è ancora la chiave con cui abbiamo letto e con cui leggeremo dopo questa poesia, soprattutto per le prime righe, quando si dice di inventare un linguaggio nuovo. E inventare un linguaggio nuovo mi fa molto piacere dirlo, dall'antichità di queste sale.
Greetings. My name is Rodney Ford. I'm the Cultural Affairs Officer at the U.S. Embassy here in Rome, Italy. In May 1997, the Embassy had the pleasure of welcoming Lawrence Ferlinghetti for a program on the readings of his poems at the Center for American Studies. Prior to the program, the streets around the center were filled with an enthusiastic crowd waiting to meet him and to hear his readings. Ferlinghetti was a fierce defender of freedom of expression and freedom of speech. His legacy as a cultural ambassador for the United States is critically important. Today, in his honor and to remember him, I will read one of his poems, Challenges for Young Poets. Invent a new language anyone can understand. Climb the Statue of Liberty. Reach for the unattainable. Kiss the mirror and write what you see and hear. Dance with wolves and count the stars, including the unseen. Be naive, innocent, non-cynical, as if you had just landed on Earth, as indeed you have, as indeed we all have, astonished by what you have fallen upon. Write living newspapers. Be a reporter from outer space, filing dispatches to some supreme managing editor who believes in full disclosure and has a low tolerance level for hot air. Write an endless poem about your life on Earth or elsewhere. Read between the lines of human discourse. Avoid the provincial. Go for the universal. Think subjectively. Write objectively. Think long thoughts in short sentences. Don't attend poetry workshops. But if you do, don't go to learn how to, but to learn what. What's important to write about. Don't bow down to critics who have not themselves written great masterpieces. Resist much, obey less. Secretly liberate any being you see in a cage. Write short poems in the voice of birds. Make your lyrics truly lyrical. Birdsong is not made by machines. Give your poems wings to fly to the treetops. The much quoted dictum from William Carlos Williams, "No ideas but in things," is okay for prose, but it lays a dead hand on lyricism, since things are dead. Don't contemplate your navel in poetry and think the rest of the world is going to think it's important. Remember everything, forget nothing. Work on a frontier, if you can find one. Go to sea or work near water and paddle your own boat. Associate with thinking poets, they're hard to find. Cultivate dissidence and critical thinking. First thought, best thought, may not make for the greatest poetry. First thought may be worst thought. What's on your mind? What do you have in mind? Open your mouth. Stop mumbling. Don't be so open-minded that your brains fall out. Question everything and everyone. Be subversive, constantly questioning reality and the status quo. Be a poet, not a huckster. Don't cater, don't pander, especially not to possible audiences, readers, editors, or publishers. Come out of your closet. It's dark in there. Raise the blinds, throw open your shutter windows, raise the roof, unscrew the locks from the doors, but don't throw away the screws. Be committed to something outside yourself. Be militant about it, or ecstatic. To be a poet at 16 is to be 16. To be a poet at 40 is to be a poet. Be both. Wake up and pee. The world's on fire. Have a nice day.